and I'm gonna try and get it into the hole. I just did it. Okay, I'm coming up.
This is usually fairly frightening. I'm gonna make something great.
Hey everybody, how are you? I'm Ty, I'm back, and I'm going to pull this engine out. If you haven't seen the last episode, I scrapped my MX3 to get the power steering out of it to put in here. To do the power steering in this engine bay, I have to pull the engine and transmission out to replace the steering rack, install everything nice, all have it painted, you know what I mean? So this engine's gotta come out. All right, the engine's out of the twin engine MX3. That was easy. The way I've made everything, I made everything to come apart very easy. My exhaust for my turbo, I removed one V-band and the entire exhaust comes with the turbo. All I gotta do is undo the drain and feed for the turbo and that one V-band and she comes off. Obviously unplugged the O2 here. So this stuff is ready to go back onto the new engine. So this is when things get confusing, okay? So this engine is getting pulled out because I want to do power steering. So I'm doing power steering to the front, which the steering rack needs pulled out and all that good stuff. So that needs to be done. One reason why the engine's getting pulled out. Another reason why this engine's getting pulled out is because I want it into the rear. Reason being is this engine is fully built. This engine, I have no doubts it will last a long time for me, which I'm very stoked about. And it is much more difficult to pull an engine out of the back because I can't go down anymore because I have frames to reinforce the car and I can't go down anymore. I also can't bring the transmission down anymore. So if I break a tranny or engine, it's gotta go up. And it's takes about 25 more minutes, 30 minutes, something like that, I'm not sure. This engine to pull out of the front literally took me 25 minutes. This morning I just farted, or yesterday I farted around with it a bit. The only thing I farted around with last night was moving the car to the back of my shop. So I've got it literally about an inch away. I can barely fit my fingers in there. And that was most of the work. That took about half an hour to do by myself. But dropping the engine by myself took 25 minutes. All I do is I remove the wiring from the ECU, bring it out with the engine. I've got to do the tranny mounts, get the axles out, and basically this cross member, fuel lines, and she comes out because there's no heater cord, there's nothing. So everything's simplified. It makes my life easier and it's a joy to do every time I have to do it. So this time, this engine doesn't need fully disassembled because it's going right into the back, but I've got to take this transmission off because I don't want that transmission in the back because this transmission is an LSD. And the LSD transmission I want for the front because I want to be able to turn. And every tranny that I put into the back has a welded diff, so turning is impossible if it was in the front. Because if you turn the wheels and the transmission is completely welded, it hops around and skips, it's just not fun. So I've got to pull that tranny off. I've also got to check the internals because I do think there is damage, but I'm not sure, I'm gonna have to double check. So what has to come off of this engine? I've got to take the headers off because I'm going to put them back onto the engine that's going into the front, which is this one. So this engine is going into here. It's gonna have these headers on it, that intake on it, because this intake matches the wiring harness for the front. Like I said, this gets confusing. So I really gotta think about this because literally that harness for my wiring for the injectors will not plug into the back engine harness. So if I put that intake on this engine that is going into the back, I would go to plug it in and it wouldn't plug in. So I've gotta leave this for the front engine. This intake is going onto the front. So yeah, basically that's all I gotta do. Pull off the tranny, pull off the headers, and then I can put this engine aside until I'm going to put it into the back. Okay, I just ran into another problem. I took the headers off, and as you can see, there's quite a bit of oil right here. Every port in the headers had bad oil except these two right here. But these guys are just caked. So I'm kind of thinking that I have bad valve stem seals. I've always had a problem with this car smoking a lot, or this engine smoking a lot when it was first starting up. So I would fire it up and it would be blue smoke, really bad, and then it would go away after it warmed up. So I'm not sure what's going on. The compression's all good, but there's a lot of oil coming out of the exhaust, and the intake side looked good for the intake valves. They're all clean, so weird. Weird. I'm gonna have to look into that and rip her apart. I pulled the plug out and they're pretty black. So I think it is kind of in the combustion chamber, but I also did look down into the piston, where the piston is, into the cylinder. You won't be able to see, but it's clean in there. You won't be able to see it, but the pistons like are literally still shiny because the engine's brand new. So I'm gonna have to figure this one out. Yeah, thinking back, I really do think that they are valve stem seals, because when I would first start it up, she would smoke like really bad. She always did that, this engine. It has a fresh rebuild on it, so whoever did it probably didn't do the valve stem seals for whatever reason, which doesn't make sense. I have some. I have that stuff in stock all the time. Then I have to take the old valve stem seals off and then install new ones. Hopefully that's the only issue. The reason why I think it's that is because when it would sit and then get started, it would smoke, and then once it was done smoking, it was done smoking. Because there's oil at the in your head when you turn off the engine, and it once it's sitting there, it has nowhere to go and goes in through the valve stem seals and into the combustion chamber. So, and then when you fire it up, your cylinder's covered in oil, so it's burning it off. So hopefully that's the problem. So I'm definitely gonna do that. I'm just gonna have to get a spring compressor, and then I can do it. So I'm gonna have to do that. Yeah, I wasn't planning it, but I think this whole engine's gotta come apart right down to the heads and block. I'm not gonna take it further than the heads and the block. I hope not, but I'm gonna have to take the oil pan off right now and see what I can see, and hopefully everything's cool in there. The oil that did come out was good, so hopefully I just have to do the valve stem seals. Because look at how oily that is, wow. All right, I did some running around today and I borrowed a sick tool from a guy down the road. And it's a valve tool that he made. And you basically just stick your tool on the end And then you use this for leverage to pop your spring and retainers out of your head. So I've done that. I just wanted to do it once to make sure that I was gonna be able to do it. I didn't wanna have to, I never filmed the first thing. Anyways, took it out and saw that the valve seal was pretty sheared. Like, look at this. It's a mess. And like the rubber's on, not on right. Anyways, not good. So from what I've looked at here, the stock springs have no inner spring. The built one, the built Ferreras do. So there is the Ferrera built one. It's also a little bit taller. This is stock, this is Ferrera. This is obviously an upgraded one, but I'm wondering what the actual difference in spring rates each have. So I'm gonna go to Baden Automotive and I'm going to test them with their tester. I did not know they had one. It'd be good to know and show people what the gains and what the losses are and if it's worth the money. So we're gonna check that out. And I'm also gonna see if this actual valve seal is got enough clearance. I'm gonna ask them. They're the pros, so I'm gonna ask them. All right, so the stock springs are about 120 according to this gauge. And the Ferrera double springs with the spacer is, so you go down to full lock and then down five ticks.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
It's 170. So these are like much, much stronger and they've got the smaller spring inside so it'll help valve float. So yeah, I'm definitely gonna stick with these if I can get them to work. Okay, that is very oily in this, same here. So these two have big problems and I think this one does too. So I'm gonna take the valve cover off, distributor off, and then check those seals out. All right, I got the valve covers off. I got the distributor out. I got the timing gear off. All that stuff is gone. So now I have my valve train. These are upgraded valve springs and valves. These are all titanium valves and titanium caps, retainers, all that good stuff. So I've got to remove the retainers that are deep in there. And the way you do that is you compress the spring with anything really, depends how you want to go about it, and remove the little clips that are in there, the retainers. And then the spring is released, then you can remove the spring and all the retainers, and then you can see what I would like to see, and that would be the seals for the valves. That's what I want to see. I'm thinking that there's a big problem because there's a lot of oil coming out of the back. A lot of oil, so. Right now, I'm going to show you what I kind of figured out to get them out. So I borrowed a homemade valve tool from down the road, and I just basically clamped a receiver from a truck onto my table, and then I use my leverage down here, and then I do what I gotta do. I'll show you. Okay, so the craziest thing just happened. I've been taking the valves off, obviously, and I was gonna leave, and I've compressed air to the cylinder, and I was like, okay, if I just remove the air slowly, hopefully the valves will stay in. And I was so dumb. I shouldn't have removed the air. I should have just put them back together and left. I thought they'd stay because it was in a used engine, and you know what I mean? I thought it would stick enough, but it didn't, and one fell in. One did stay. So there's one that stayed, there's the one that's in the cylinder. So after I was like really mad for a few minutes, I'm like, you know what, I'm gonna have some fun with this and try and sneak it back in there. So I went in with a Allen key and I fished it around and I actually got it back into the exhaust port hole. Just like so. You can just see the tip right there. So now I'm going to turn the engine, get the piston to come up a bit, and then I'm gonna try and grab it and shove it back into the hole. Let's see how this works. Okay, I got it with there. Sorry, I can't even speak right now. I got it with the needle nose. Now I'm gonna try and get it into the hole. I just did it. Okay, I'm coming up. Right on. Look at that. She's in there. Holy crap, what a relief. Okay, now I can leave again since it is New Year's. But holy, just for reference, look at that piston. Look how clean that piston is. That's amazing. Valve's back in, looking sick. All right, so now I've got to do the valve stem seals. But I'm done for today. This video is gonna be up after the New Year, so have a happy New Year. I'm gonna make sure to have some New Year drinks. But I'll see you the next time I'm gonna film. I'll probably film tomorrow. All right, I'm going to remove these two springs and retainers. This guy has a lot of cake in there, that's for sure. This is a royal pain in the butt, but got these four done. So I've got a couple more to do. I've already done the other side and everything. So I'm hoping that's gonna fix my problem because there's an excessive amount of oil coming through here. The engine ran great. It was just smoke on first startup. So hopefully it's all good. Kind of worried about it. Today's New Year's Day and Jacqueline decided she wanted to come to the shop and she never really wrenched on cars ever, but I'm telling her to take this engine apart because it needs to be done. So why not learn the hard way? This was the second set of valves I've done and this was the first, and I've never done valve seals before. So I'm gonna take them out and just make sure that they're on good because I don't wanna do this again. So I'm just gonna triple check and she's gonna be doing that engine for now. Okay, I'm gonna do a little bit of explaining what I'm doing here. So these are your valves. Since I have a dual overhead cam, I have one intake side and one exhaust side. So these are two intake, these are two exhaust, and they get pressed down with the cams, obviously, and they let air in, and this one lets air out. So what I'm doing here is I'm replacing the seals that hold the valves in. So to do so, I have to compress the spring, because a spring is what holds this valve up. Compress the spring, and when the spring gets compressed,
I can take out these two clips. There's two clips and they look like this. So you gotta take them out. And then you can take this whole assembly out. Then there's a spacer on the bottom and then a seal. And the seals look like this. A little spring on there just to keep some tension onto the valve. So this gets slid onto the valve and it clips in. You just gotta press them in very lightly and they go bink and they pop right onto the valve stems. So here we are, pushing it down, taking them out, removing it, replacing the seal, and then putting it all back together. So what I'm doing is pressing down with that black tool you see me use, and then get my fingers and kind of wiggle them around and get them in there. But they will not go in. You can't just put them in right now because it has to be compressed. So you have to push the spring beyond. There's the notch on the valve and then they can be put in. It is very difficult. At this point, I'm actually pretty good at it. I've done this whole side and then these two, and now I've got these in probably like half an hour, which is way quicker than I was yesterday. So I redid them all because I didn't want to have any flaws and I was learning how to do it. I've never done the valve stem seals ever. And I have lots of them, so I'm just making sure they're right because I don't want to redo this again. If this is the problem, which I think it is, maybe the engine won't burn oil anymore and that'd be sick. This is a homemade tool that Gyno made. Here's what I do. I stick a magnet, a heavy duty computer magnet inside. So when the retainer clips come out, they just go right to the magnet and I don't lose them. So I've got compressed air going into where the piston or the actual spark plug goes. So it's holding the piston down and it's pushing air up to the valve so the valves don't pop out. So to get these clips out, I'm just pushing down slowly. And sometimes they don't come out right away, but I'm gonna, if they're stubborn, you gotta poke them with something. I'm just gonna poke them with the tool here. There you go. Okay. And then now it's released. So, as you can see, there's the clips in there. So don't lose them. Don't lose them in the engine. If you lose them in the engine, you gotta find them. Because if you don't find them, you're gonna crunch everything later on. And that sucks. So, now I can take the spring out. If you can get in there with your fingers, do it. So, this is a dual valve spring. It's good for high revving. And these are titanium retainers and clips and all that. Good stuff. So now I'm gonna go in there and get my little seal. So basically, I forgot my little spacer guy, but you gotta make sure everything's out of the way so you don't wreck anything. And also don't try and scratch anything because that's not gonna help you in the long. Get some needle nose pliers. Grab the seal. It's just that little thing I showed you before. It's just a little rubber guy. Grab it with some pressure, not too much. Spin it back and forth. Change position. Just wiggle it out. If it takes you 10 minutes for one, it takes you 10 minutes. See, there we go. She's out. This one doesn't seem like it was damaged too much, so. Don't know if it was leaking, but who cares? Let's replace them, because they're probably old. This engine was rebuilt in 2013 and hasn't really ran at all, so I don't know if they dried up or what. So here's my new one. I'm gonna put some oil on it and then put it on. And now I'm just gonna go over top of the valve, slide it on nicely. Use your finger if you're more comfortable with it. Slide it on all the way down and then get a socket that fits it good. I got a double box end 12, and I'm just doing this by hand, like just like this. Make sure you're straight, and then push it and it'll pop in. And now I'm gonna put some pressure on it. Pop right on, perfect. Just gotta make sure she's on, and then you're done. Then you gotta put it back together, put the spring in, spacer in, like so. Here's my spacer, here's my spring. Make sure everything's like seated. Get your grease. You gotta grease in here because you're gonna lose your retainers if you don't. I always just use whatever I've got. And then do an oil change after the first startup. Just get some in there. Get your clips. One clip, two clip. So I told you not to put it in before, right? But you have to before you put this little piece on that goes and presses it in, because you can't get it in there later. So since the grease is in there, hold it. But now I need to get my bar on and put it in. So now you don't want the magnet inside this guy because it'll just pull them out. So you don't want that. Put that away. And then push it on carefully. And there you go. I struggled for a bit on that one. The camera's in the way, but she's on. Gotta make sure she's on there. Good. Not gonna pop off. That's how you do it. It's not hard, but it's not easy. All right, I'm all done with doing the valve seals. So now I'm going to put the cams back in. And just like that, cams out, valve seals done, and cams back in, valve covers on. That was a lot of work, but it's done now, and that's all that matters, and I'm thinking that it won't leak anymore. I'm hoping for that, so I'll let you know if it doesn't work or works or what it's gonna do, but the engine's going back together. It's good, because now I don't have all these boxes full of parts. All right, so that's it for today. Have a good one. We'll see you in the next time. And like, comment, subscribe. I'm gonna make something great. That's my